Hello everybody, and welcome back to the Tarama Island series, where we try to build self-sustainable island in Citiesskylines too. In today's episode, we're going to try to increase the income of this island. Since we started with this harbor over here, and we're getting a lot of ships coming in, that creates a little problem with the new update of economy 2.0, and we gotta fix that one. Otherwise, we will run out of money really quick. We're gonna try to bring more income through the industries, and I thought about reducing the outside incoming goods, for example, the farming and the food and everything, and try to go in that direction and create our own food here. Maybe creating a little bit more so we can actually start exporting things to the mainland, for example. And that would give us some leverage and a little bit more space to actually breathe with the new economy update. Last episode, let's talk about that real quick. We have placed the residential on this island over here. There is some expansion possible over here. We had a small area where businesses can open their stores. And this part here is where the industries of this island exist. And in this case, banding actually this area and having a little bit of lumber industries and farming also. But farming will be probably not down here, but rather somewhere. I move the camera, it will be probably right here. So I will keep it a little bit further away from the sea. The idea is to keep it away from the salty soil. If I keep it deeper inside here, we would have more fresh water over here, and that would give us the possibility to create some farming. And we're gonna try to create enough income to balance this harbor. So if I go inside the game right now, we see there is a big arrow down here, and I'm losing approximately $5,000 an hour. This is a lot for my city right now, but we could balance that pretty easy if we get some income through the residentials and the commercials and the industries. So let's start doing that. We see that the demand for population is going up. I'm having like 21 residentials more every hour, which is very cool. Let's go and try to start expand the housings, get more people inside, and then later on, after that, we are going to expand and try to create a small lumber industry over here, and a little bit bigger part over here will be farming. So let's dive in and try to build our industries. So the first thing is we're going to try to get more residentials inside here first. And after that, I will have then to create the industry for people to work. There we have it. We already have people moving on, and their housings are built just now. So we're gonna give it a break since the demand went down by a lot. So the low density, and I don't want to go into medium right away. I feel like that would be a little bit too much, but let's keep it in the low density first. So let's go here and start to create the lumber industry. I'm gonna set down the road first and see afterwards how we gotta place the fields. I'm just gonna use the alleyways, and I gotta toggle this one and start over here. Gonna have a connection coming down here. There we go. So this will be the area. I will connect also this one. I thought first not connecting it, but now I will connect it. And this might be a little bit too steep actually for cars to come down here. So let's fix that part. definitely want to have the connection. Let's use the slope tool. Keep it this way and like this. So the road can be... Actually, let's do it with the whole thing over here. And so we don't have the problem to actually create the road. Go down here, 90. And then this one comes up this way. Not exactly what I was looking for. But anyways, let's go up here and create a little curve. This way, exactly. And just to get rid of all the cliffs over here, let's have it nice smoothed out so it blends in. Go a little bit bigger with the brush and blend in this as well. Here we go. Yeah, I like that. It should be like this. It could be all different size and everything. And the height should be also going up and down. Okay, this road looks a little bit weird. So let's get rid of this. Go again to the slope tool. Go down with the brush and slope it from here to here. Just nice slope like this. Then create the road. And then have this one smoothed out a little. So since everything is nicely placed, I'm gonna have another connection over here as well. The gravel road. Go in this direction. And I need another connection that goes also in here again. And later on, I'll probably have it also expand all over here. So let's start over here and placing the lumber. But first of all, I want to get rid of all the trees. That is more... I want to have it more artificially placed here rather than just random placements. Let's get this to 100. Toggle this one and then remove everything. Okay, then let's place the trees. And for that, I thought it maybe makes more sense if I place trees, for example, that are palms. Let's see first, what kind of palms do we have? I want to have a line. I want to have all ages, actually. We have all ages. And I will place some lines and see how they add together. Interesting, let's take another road. This is the other palm. They look beautiful. And this is the last one. So interesting is actually this one. I like the height of it. Probably the highest of all. And I do like also this one. This one has like more filling bushy thing up here. The leaves, it has a lot of leaves. I can imagine a mixture of all of them. And maybe the ones that are on the lower spaces here, flatter ones, I will take the higher versions of them. And for the slope here, I'll probably go with something more, either with this or with this one. I think it would look much better if we have that one this way. And I might not go and create them this different ages in one line, but I'd rather have two lines of one age and then two lines of a different one and so on and so forth. So we create like a little aging system in our lumber industry. So let me get rid of this again. And then start placing them. Have it, and I will leave it for a sec and just to check if really the game will add number to the place.
A few moments later,
well, I have let it run for a few minutes, and as I can see, nothing has changed. But let's just keep this in mind and go to the next one. And now we're gonna go and start our farming area. Very fertile land here, so it is perfect to have farming industry right here. So let's go and put it down. So with that, we're gonna start first with some roads. They're gonna be a little bit like fitting the terrain and going around. And they will fit the topography. I will just enable here the topography and see exactly where it's running, and I'll only have maybe a road coming out here, or would be like a little bit too complicated. You will have too many things going around, so let's keep it simple. I will have it run through with this line and then connect again over here, and then we create this place as a farming area. So let's have it go straight first. Have it, and now we can start placing the farmings. Now we gotta do some detailing. I'm gonna push back this farms a little bit further away from the highway and go with the line tool and some grease go line here to create difference between the farming and the highways, a visual border between them. And this is way too close to it. So let's do that and come back again. Well, we do have it now, and the last thing we need to do is actually to connect everything with the water and the sewage and get some electricity over here. In this case, I will get the electricity from this one over here and run it all the way here. So it would have been actually pretty good if I place everywhere the lights on the side of the roads. And the water, it might be easier to get it from this area here. So let's get the water over there. And the water is gone. And I'm not having enough water sources. So I'm gonna add one. Gonna add one of the small ones. Just here, somewhere, maybe here. Yeah, that looks perfect for it. That will get the water issue gone away. And I wonder, yeah, it went up. Okay, so we good. What else do we need? Energy, let's check the energy. Do I have enough energy? Yes, I'm perfectly in here in the green. So that means very soon I'll be having the issue with energies if I expand a little bit more. Other than that, let me say, do I create any lumber is the question. Here, employees zero. Is it because I'm having not enough people working? So yeah, there is enough space for people to move in now. And there we have it, the issue of not enough residential. So let's get them moved then. The farming over here looks perfectly nice. We have the small lumber industry here, and we have added some more residential. The next one would be, in the next episode probably, it will be to detail a little bit more this space, create a little industry next to it, and also some housings over here. So people who work at this place will actually live also nearby it. So to have this would be amazing. Because then I could have more residentials in here and not concentrate everything over here. And this place will be rather, especially for this harbor. So I wonder if I'm exporting anything. I'm just going to check that one for the last time. See, we do have some surplus. So that's pretty cool. That means that brings a little bit of money inside. So if we get that one, I see already like the petrol problem, it's always there, but we can't, I don't want to go with the oil industry. Maybe later have a small one over here. I know that there is some oil over here, and that's it. So I see we have some criminals going around here. Maybe the last piece I will put down is small police station. Will cost us a little bit more. But then we have the security that we need. So we haven't fixed yet the amount of service upkeeping that we have to do, but over the time it will be the case that we fix it very, very soon. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and I really appreciate you if you watched it to this point. And I hope you subscribe to this channel to keep up with all what we got in the future. And you enjoy all of this, of this series. Leave a comment, like this video, and I see you next time. Bye bye.